So I guess I only have a couple days today for 8th. So I'm gonna continue on this going to study. And the 8th is when I have to get our next party member rescued. Okay, let's get this. And yeah, welcome back to my channel. We're playing Persona 3. reload. I have to remember that I have plans tonight. That's it for today. Yes, I don't have to worry. I can go back to the old couple. I need to see if I can finish their social link. I feel like I might get closer to them. That Rika for soon. Yes! We can find the max of the social link. He's asleep.
Please, just wait a little while longer. Even if the tree is gone, you still live on inside us.
Wait. He's sleeping, sleep talking. Looks like he's taking a nap. Take a closer look. Yep, literally, sitting like that. Or no, yeah, sitting on this front of books.
We recently closed the book on a difficult matter, so I suppose the relief has put me at ease. It's the middle of the day, but I feel awfully sleepy.
It's either, low blood pressure or, old age. Are you relieved?
While we're all here, I think it's time we told you. The truth is, we sent a letter to Gecko Khan. We asked them to go ahead and put the persimmon tree down.
But why?
Just the reaction I was hoping for. It was more than worth it to surprise you like that. Sorry for doing this without running it by you. When we went to visit the tree together, I met a school faculty member on my way back. He told me the administration is planning to put up a new school building where the tree currently is. It would be selfish of an old man like me to deprive those young people of new learning opportunities. Helping children reach their potential is more important than clinging on to old memories. I think our son would agree. He was a teacher after all.
That's true.
Yes, we had a long talk about it, and this was the conclusion we came to.
You really set an example for young people, being so considerate to old folks like us. We pray with our son in heaven that more kind souls like you will graduate from Gecko Khan. Here, we'd like you to have this. It's the first fruit produced by the persimmon tree. A little rough around the edges, just like our son. Fine deer was the one who suggested we give it to you.
Aww. It must be something very meaningful to the both of them. The deep gratitude reached my heart.
Thank you. we now still upon one. The ultimate form of the Highlander within thyself.
And we raked it up. Okay. We're making an alternate persona.
Get on with our lives. We're too old to waste a single day. If we kick the bucket while wasting our days away, I'm sure he'd laugh at us from heaven.
It's hard on the parents to have such a well-respected son. Oh my. Does it sound like I'm boasting?
Aww. The three of you chat until sunset. I parted ways with the other couple and went back to the dorm.
Alright, it's time. Let's get going.
Should we talk about this some more? I still think this is a bad idea. How are you scared of ghosts, but totally fine with this?
Because ghost. I don't know. Because ghosts are the unknown?
Because stuff you can't see is way creepier.
Actually, I'm more worried about the things I can see. Like bats and knives.
You mean baseball bats or, bats, like bat, the animal bats? I mean, what? Are you afraid of Batman? Yep, strike hard.
You're actually excited about this?
I'm sorry to even torment you, Junpei. This is what you get for torment, being rude to me when I was the female protagonist in Persona 3 Portable. Which I should do a let's play of that too. Just to torment him even more, because it is even worse during the monorail fight because of how rude he is.
Wait,
are we going to a place like this, like that, this late at night? It's not easy to stand up for a stand-up guy like me. Would you stop complaining, alright? It'll be nothing. All we have to do is take the monorail to the station. That's so hard about that. That's not exactly what I meant by it. Not easy. You know, you could Don, you actually be scarier than the pucks that we're bound to run into. By the way, are these punks gonna be really scary?
Who the hell are these guys? Check out those rags. They're from Gecko High. Hello, man. This is even worse than
me. How do you even tell that Junpei's a Gekkon that stared at? Yeah, him. I'm cool, right?
seeing is, being here was ruining our mind. Beat it, goatee.
He's the one attacking it, too. Yeah, we're totally nuts. Ride and die. Nope. What room? I don't see a room.
I can read just fine.
you just say?
She said, hi. Do you have any weed? I'll say she doesn't have a dad. Spoilers for you guys. You two of them sound intimidating. Yukari, what made his handle it?
Man, I feel sorry for you, Goatee. This bitch is a real pain in the ass, isn't she?
I was just gonna check and see if you guys have any, so I don't think that part went through. Didn't go through. Sorry, you just crossed the line. You don't think you're going to go home alive now.
Should we find out?
I definitely need to edit some voices out, huh?
Yeah, now I remember. Shinjiro Arigaki. You're from Gecko High too, aren't you? Damn it, you're gonna regret this! Oh man, Senpai! That was awesome! I remember you. You guys were in Aki's room at the hospital. You
idiots. Go home.
You don't belong here. Wait.
Sorry, but there's something we need to know before we leave.
Did Aki tell you to come here?
No. No, he didn't. Yep.
Yes, that's right. How'd you know?
The rumor's been going around. Those girls who wind up in the hospital were here talking shit every night. They brag about all the stuff they did to some girl named Yamagishi.
Yamagishi? You mean Fuka Yamagishi from 2E? You were picking on her?
That's why people are saying it's Yamagishi's ghost that did it.
Yamagishi-san's ghost? Wait, what do you mean by that?
You guys don't know?
Oh, what happened?
This Yamagishi-go might be dead.
What?
I heard she hasn't been home in over a week.
Wait, what? I thought she was just out recovering. So, you mean she's still missing?
So much for that ghost story. Mr. Akoda is the homeroom teacher for 2E, right? Does he know about this?
I get it, Aki. Still trying to make up for the past. It's you who can't let go. Nothing. Anyways, that's all I know. We done here?
Yeah, totally. Thanks a lot.
Initiation.
We didn't need your help. You really saved us. I was gonna do that. Come on, we didn't need your help. Well, I'm just standing there while these two are getting hurt.
Thank you for helping us, and for sharing what you know. That was really nice of you. Oh, sorry.
Just don't come here again.
Dude, I'm drenched in cold sweat. But man, our Waki-san told us was shocking, huh? Oh, Kajiro-senpai knows Kajiro-senpai know what we found out about Yamagashi-san. The fact that she's missing is no small matter. Man, we're totally gonna get yelled at for doing that without permission. I can already see it happening. Huh, is something in there? Let's chat. She disappeared. It began with Let's Go Story, but it has developed into a serious situation. We have to do something. Okay, what's about him? Seriously, going to a place like that, there are limits to how reckless you can be. I mean, I'm proud of you guys for trying to gather information, but a little more careful next time. Sorry, guy. That literally. And try to show his power with some punks, and got the police called on him. Love you, Hakihiko, though. Who's it this time? Say text message. Oh, it's you. Okay. He's like, now I'm going to the hermit. I haven't seen my iChat for a while. Okay. Oh, it's you. Winchester, could you free up your day tomorrow for me? There's a lot to be done for her case. So I'm going to acquire your assistance. If you have any urgent affairs, then I suggest you sell them by the end of today. I already did it all. My affairs, I got one social link done. Like, completely done. Then I'm gonna study. So, we're supposed to gather in front of the factory office during lunch. Okay. Be honest, I don't feel like we're doing it. But we have no choice. And asking Mr. Oliver for his aspiration sounds like a total pain in the butt. They're so lame, especially compared to when we went through that spot behind the station last night. that night. Yeah, that night.
Oh, Irijo-senpai. Why are you here?
Same reason you are. Mr. Ikoda, I'm here to ask you about a student named Fuka Yamakishi.
Please, I never thought it'd turn out this way. Fuka. Hey, I remember you.
What did you do to Yamakishi?
Hold on, Kirijo-kun. This isn't an interrogation. Stop scaring her.
Oh, she's gonna interrogate. And she's gonna make you lose your job. It's not that she's a Karen. She owns this place. She owns the entire town.
Ryama, don't have to say anything if you don't want to. You wouldn't want to give her the wrong idea.
She always looked so frazzled whenever I gave her a hard time. That's when I realized she may be a model student, but deep down she's just like us. And because of that, I knew exactly which buttons to push. You were just messing with her earlier that day, too. It was May 29th. We took Fuka to the gym and locked the door from the outside.
Inside.
That's mixed up in a whole different level because, well, Dark Hour, but yeah, it's definitely messed up. Who was supposed to do that to you? In the school! In this school! You've been traumatized for the rest of your life. Next morning,
she was found lying outside the front gate. I went to the gym to let Fuka out, but the door was still locked. So I opened it and went inside, but she wasn't there. We all freaked out. Starting that night, we went out looking for her. And every night, another one of us wouldn't come back. And then they all ended up like Maki.
I see.
Mr. Ikoda. All this time you've been reporting Yamagishi is absent due to illness. But the truth of the matter is that she was missing. You had to have known this. Explain yourself.
I was thinking of the students, of course.
No, you weren't. You're thinking of your own job.
You children may not understand, but we have to consider the future of everyone affected.
Yeah, no wonder, what did your teacher think you're SOB?
So you chose not to report a missing child for the good of the class, and not because you didn't want the police involved.
It was in her best interest. I wouldn't want her records to be stained by something like this. Her parents agreed.
So to protect your career, you ignored your responsibility as a teacher. Despicable.
You're despicable. You're worse than Niska, the gum on my shoe.
I didn't mean, I was just...
That's enough. You can go now. We'll handle the rest.
Shadow?
No doubt about it. Up until now, we've never been able to predict who exactly would become. words, it doesn't just happen randomly. They actually get drawn in. I realize now, after seeing all of this, they're clearly targeting humans. Shadows are most definitely the enemy of mankind.
Tuck and Teddy.
At our dorm tonight. That should be the safest place. If you hear the voice, tell us immediately. And don't leave your room, no matter what happens. If you can manage that, you should be fine. Don't worry. Yamagishi should be alright as well.
Yeah, we also went to the same dean school of figuring this stuff out. So he might actually get captured. Which, yeah, there's a reason why my name's Dean Winchester.
Yori and Takiba too. We'll meet after school in the student council to discuss tonight's operation.
Tonight?
Yes. We are going to rescue Fuka Yamagishi. My guess is right. She's still inside the school.
Understood.
Good. You're all here. Tonight, we're infiltrating the campus. Our objective is to rescue Fuka Yamagishi.
I don't get it. Are you saying Yamagishi is inside the school somewhere?
Yep.
And why are we doing this at night? At midnight, this place turns into...
Exactly. That's how Yamagishi wandered into Tartarus.
Wait! You mean Yamagishi-san's been over there ever since she got locked in the gym?
Yep.
That's right.
That was 10 days ago! No matter how you look at it, she's gotta be...
Don't lose hope just yet. Tartarus only appears during the dark hour. So where does it go for the rest of the day?
It doesn't exist. No one knows.
That's a good point.
This is just a theory. But I think time flows differently in Tartarus. So even though it's been 10 days for us, it could have only been 10 hours for her. There's a chance she's still alive.
Wow, you think so? But wait, isn't the dark hour pretty brutal though? Even for us, how could she last 10 days worth in there?
That is true. And even if she is still alive, we might not be able to get to her.
Are you just gonna abandon her then?
Nope, I'm going all in.
I have an idea. Let's try to enter Tartarus the same way Yamagishi did. We'll go to the gym and wait for midnight. That'll be the quickest way.
Is that really gonna work?
In all honesty, I can't say I fully agree with this. If something goes wrong, you could all end up lost in Tartarus too. But...
I'm not just gonna stand here and do nothing. There's a chance we can save her. I never forgive myself. If you guys aren't with me, then I'm going in on my own.
I'm going with him.
Senpai?
Alright. We know it's risky, but we also can't just leave her there.
Right. And we won't know until we try.
Guess we're sneaking into the school then.
Yep.
In that case, I've got just the thing.
You do?
This is a problem. I can't get a hold of the chairman.
Well, that's not a big deal, right?
Why are we in our, summer uniforms?
There is one issue. Without the chairman's help, I'm not sure how we can get inside the school.
No need to worry. I've got it all set.
All set? I'm explosive. All right, I'll let you handle this.
There's no time to waste. Let's go.
An actual explosive?
No.
All I did was unlock a door.
Okay, that was funny. Yeah, it is French.
Why are they talking in different languages anyway?
And it's basically she's saying good work. Excellent. Actually, I never took French, so.
Can we turn
on the lights? I honestly know more Japanese than German and Spanish of all things than French, because first of all, Spanish, I live near closer to Mexico than anywhere else. So I do know a few. Then Japanese because, honestly, I love anime and all that. And then German because that's the actual foreign language I took. Can we turn on the lights? Okay. Yeah, no.
Maybe I should go to the faculty office too. It sounds interesting.
You're not planning to do something unethical under my supervision, are you? I suppose you'll need to be executed.
Hey, come on! Obviously, I was joking.
All I meant by interesting was that there's a higher chance of finding the key there.
You're right, nice save.
Excuses. Let's head to the janitor's room. Iori, you're coming with us. Alright, let's get this over with.
I should head to the faculty office. And we could go look for the chess answers. Not, but still. Jupiter walks so we failed so we can run.
What?
There's someone else here? We gotta hide. We didn't hide very well. Let's hurry.
I know. My phone! Why now? And of course, it's just spam. I mean, that would freak most people out, right? Come on, the thing just rang out of nowhere.
I get that. But why are you scared of ghosts when we fight demon-like things? And that's my question. I mean, understand. Say, I named myself Dean Winchester, being afraid of heights. Or, I don't know, clowns, when you fight stuff like that. But ghosts when you actually fight ghost-like things. Does not make sense. Isn't easy open.
Oh,
There doesn't seem to be anyone in the factory office. It might be a good time to enter. I can see. Morgan? Jim?
Really? Let me see. Yeah, this is it. I'm sure they won't mind if we borrow this. Okay, let's go. We're supposed to meet up with everyone in the main hallway.
Did you find the key?
You
know, I heard a scream that sounded kind of
familiar. Okay, Junpei.
Huh?
It was her phone.
Wait, you actually did? I was just kidding.
Do you want to take this outside?
Guys, come on.
Alright, we'll divide into teams again. Three of you will enter Tartarus. One of you will remain outside with me. Once the dark hour begins, I'll pinpoint Yamagishi's position.
I'm going in.
Same.
You come too. You can take the lead as usual.
Alright.
Then I'll be the third.
Wait a second, Yukita. Remember how I accidentally screwed up on the monorail? Give me a chance to make up for that.
No, I'm going with you, Yukari. No, I want Yukari.
Sweet. Thanks.
What's wrong, Takeba? Do you have a problem staying with Mitsuru?
No, it's fine.
It's fine, but I want Yukari. Because you are. Junpei's not a healer.
That's right. I guess I'm alone after all. Oh god. No. I don't want to hear this. Calling me. I have to go to school. Tell her I'm sorry. Huka. Oh.
We still haven't heard back from them. Transmission range is at max, too.
I hope that girl Moriyama is okay at the dorm.
Unfortunately, no place is completely safe in the dark hour. But we couldn't risk bringing her here. And having one of us stay behind to watch her wasn't an option either.
Yeah, I guess so. Well, we're all here for Yamagishi-san's sake.
I got... I must have lost consciousness. I don't see Saturn or Senpa or Junpei.
Are you awake?
Yeah.
This is the first time we've spoken outside of your room.
And tech going to the dorm. Not on the first night? Oh, yeah. Where's ours?
Don't worry. You'll see them soon. But we don't have much time to talk. Tonight, there is more than one ordeal you must face. You should hurry. She's waiting for you. You guys will need her. See you. I hope we meet again.
Okay. Mission has been lost. Oh, ice. Okay, Jacqueline. No one's up here.
Where am I? Why am I here? Please, answer me.
I got Jack Frost. That's good. Okay. Wait, what? Yeah, I don't think I answer. I'm the silent protagonist, after all. He definitely could use us. Oh, there they are. He was in a suit. Sorry about the wait.
I don't think we should enter Tartarus this way again.
Nope.
Oh yeah. Did you hear a voice on your way here? Yeah. Kinda like.
Who's there? Are you? Ruin?
Oh, it's her.
That's it? That's the voice? Wait. Didn't that come from behind us?
Yamagishi?
Yes.
Wow, you're alive! That's awesome! Never fear, the heroes are here.
Good to see you're okay. Come with us.
Thank you so much. I...
Don't worry, you're safe now.
See if I can contact Mitsuru.
What is this place? One second I was at school, and then...
It's kind of a long story. We can explain after we get out of here.
Mitsuru, can you hear me?
No good. All I hear is static.
Oh, are you hurt anywhere? You've probably seen the monsters wandering around, right?
So, there is something dangerous in here, then. I've gotten by without them finding me so far.
Wait, you've avoided them this entire time? How is that possible?
Walk.
It's hard to describe, but I can sort of tell where they are.
What do you mean? You saying you're psychic or something?
She has the same power as Mitsuru. Actually, she might be even stronger. Mitsuru's persona is always more combat-focused to begin with.
Persona?
Hang on to this.
Huh? Wait, is this a gun?
Think of it as a lucky charm. It doesn't actually fire bullets.
Okay.
Main character. I didn't know it. I just grabbed it and tried to shoot myself. Oh yeah, we get dumber. No, that explains being JP, I'm not gonna spoil it to you.
Hey, was it a full moon the night we went to the monorail?
It was.
Is something wrong?
Hey, did you see the moon on the night the dorm was attacked back in April?
It was full.
Today is June 8th. The monorail incident happened on May 9th. The assault in the dorm was on April 9th. They were all on a full moon. Mitsuru, are you there? Hey, can you hear me? Mitsuru, come in! Mitsuru!
What is that? It's much bigger than the others. And it's attacking someone.
Damn it!
What's going on? Who are we lost here?
It's one of them. My guess is right. They come every full moon. We've gotta hurry. There's two of them? Mitsuru! Takeba!
What's going on? Nothing's working!
Madasa! Gotta draw the shadows away!
Yeah, I'm on it. Hey, if it's a fight you want, then you've got it!
Akihiko, be careful. Normal attacks don't work on them.
Hey! What the?
Okay.
No, what are you doing here?
Yamagishi-san?
A persona?
I can see these monsters' weaknesses. Can it be?
Just as I thought. Mitsuru, better take your place. We'll handle these guys.
For the monster's weaknesses. Please, give me some time!
Oh, someone's gonna have to... Oh, no physical.
Best bet.
Careful analysis. Oh yeah. Maybe I should switch to him being the healer from right now. Not anymore.
Don't worry. It's over.
Oh God. You... Are you okay? Yeah. Thank goodness. Oh God.
It's all right. She's just exhausted.
Where did those two shadows come from?
Somewhere outside of Tartarus. Just like with the dorm and the monorail.
Outside, huh?
What are we gonna do about Moriyama-san? She knows about the Dark Hour and the shadows.
It doesn't matter. She's not like us, so she won't remember anything that happens in the Dark Hour. The good news is, she didn't fall victim to the shadows despite hearing their call. So I don't think she'll get drawn in again. She
be safe now.
But doesn't that mean she'll forget Yamagishi-san saved her life? That doesn't seem right. Actually, I get the feeling that things will work out. I'm sorry, Ruka. I'm so sorry. It looks like she's learned her lesson.
It was easy, but we managed to rescue Fuka, Yamagishi. The mysterious boy appeared again. His warning doesn't seem to be just a dream. But I can't make any sense of it right now. I feel way too exhausted. I should get some rest as soon as we get back to the dorm.
Good morning.
Yamagishi and Morimi are recovering nicely. They will be released from the hospital in the next few days. That's good to hear.
Precisely.
Yes, it is. We'll need to invite Yamagishi to the dorm and explain what happened. Considering the power of hers, we could definitely use her help. That's it for today, and we're going to save it in here for today. If you like my content, please subscribe if you haven't already, comment down below, and like the video, and I'll see you guys next time.